Okay, folks, well, welcome back once more to The Long Dark. And after our slight disaster at the end of our last Stalker series, we're starting a new one, and we are returning to Stalker mode. We are heading back into the sandbox. We're going to start a new game. Obviously, we're going to have to start completely from scratch. And fingers crossed, this time I won't do anything stupid like I did at the end of the last series, heading into Forlorn Muskeg. I just got a bit overexcited and just kind of went for it, and it all went a bit wrong. So yeah, we're about to go, but I'm going to start again. It does give you the chance to show you the pretty awesome Christmas loading screen, though. That's all really rather cool. So let's head into Sandbox and ignore that one. Yeah, that's cheat Sandbox. That was me exploring Forlorn Muskeg in Pilgrim mode. We could go ahead and delete that, to be honest. Let's create ourselves a new one, back up into Stalker mode, and I am actually going to start in Forlorn Muskeg. I am going to start in the region that claimed us last time round, simply because now I've had a little bit of a wander around it in Pilgrim mode. I've kind of figured out where everything is. I know that he's kind of cheating a little bit, but I know sort of vaguely where everything is, and I'm a little bit more confident this time that we'll be able to survive at least long enough to get ourselves set up and sorted to head to Mystery Lake. So, we're going to start in Forlorn Muskeg. We're going to be the woman this time because we were the bloke last time. And this is Return to Stalker. Let's go in. So, let's see where we'll spawn. Where shall we spawn? In we go. Where are we? We are not in the best of weather condition. It's virtually dark. And we are... Is that the railway line? That is the railway line. Which end of the railway line is it? Okay, right. We're out in the middle. Oh, this is possibly the worst possible place we could have spawned, to be honest, on this map. I don't think... I'm just trying to work out the closest shelter to where we are. Could very well be the main building. Okay, so basically what I've done, I have what we could consider cheated slightly, and I have been for a bit of a wander around the map in Pilgrim mode, and I vaguely know where things are, and there really is not much on this map. It's it is very much this sort of wilderness ice sheet with very, very little else on it. There are a couple of structures. There is a homestead, which is where I'm trying to get to, if I'm remembering vaguely where it is. Yep, I think I'm heading the right way, but I've also worked out the way to avoid our little problem that we had falling through the ice. Yes, it's cold, I'm aware of that. Yeah, so falling through the ice. The biggest problem with these big ice sheets here is that a lot of it is weak ice.
See, I hate being cold.
Oh, be quiet.
You do.
It's mostly weak ice out on these ice sheets in Forlorn Muskeg, so you have to be very, very careful where you go. I found that the only real way to guarantee that you're not going to fall through the ice is to stick to the snow mounds. Oh, great, we're at risk of hypothermia. Stick to the snow mounds and only cross the ice on the very narrow sections between them. If you go to a wide piece of ice, it's probably going to be weak and it will probably collapse. And because of the way it's set up, there's no guarantee you'll be able to back off it fast enough before it falls through. Okay, you can probably see now where I'm heading. Oops, and you can probably also see what I can see, which is there's a wolf between me and it. Oh great, we're at risk of frostbite now as well, just to add to our woes. At risk of hypothermia and at risk of frostbite. That's probably because our feet are wet. I guarantee you that's why. I'll show you that in a minute. I don't know. In my previous Stalker game, the one that we already were running, I can't help but think that there were some sections of the new update that didn't fully implement. There's actually some barns over there that I hadn't seen before the last time I came here. Oh great, you see now I'm stuck in that little situation. Oh, oh no. Oh no. Have I got a flare? Please tell me I've got a flare. I have a flare. Alright. Okay. I was not planning on doing this quite so soon. Go on, wolf. Run away. It's a lit flare. You hate those. Well done. Good boy. Right. Does that give us any warmth? No, it doesn't. It feels like minus... Oh, great. I've picked up another one there. Come on. You don't like these. Yeah, there we are. Thank you very much. Right. Well, I really could... Oh, I'm never going to get it that way. I'm going to have to go around this way. This is the real problem with Forlorn Muskeg. There's no way I can make that ice crossing because it will collapse. It will be weak ice. Oh, for goodness sake. Go away. I should have gone the other way, really. I should not have tried to get over to the homestead. Okay, let's try and do some sprinting. You see, I think that's going to be weak, so I don't think I'm going to be able to walk across it. I'm trying desperately now to think of another alternative option. Because I need to get to shelter, really, pretty quick. I've got wolves between me and my shelter. Oh, really, I'm attracting every single bleeding wolf. Right, you. Go. Go on. Go! Oh, no! Well, this is not going well. Okay, my scarf has been destroyed. I have various afflictions that I can't fix because I don't have any first aid supplies. The only thing I can do is treat my sprained ankle. I have a 22% hypothermia risk, a 33% frostbite risk. I'm being surrounded by wolves. My condition is 22%. I can't find any shelter. I've got three wolves walking past behind me. I'm trying to navigate across the ice without falling through it. My condition is down to 17%. This could be the shortest series I've ever done. I've got four wolves walking along behind me. I think there are some caves around the edge. And I'm really hoping that I find one. But there's a big... Oh, I've got to go this way. Oh, there's another wolf! Oh, this is ridiculous. I'm at 10% health. I've got three wolves behind me. I've got one wolf ahead of me. I am being properly stalked. Oh, I'm wolf dinner. Well, this hasn't gone well. Oh, dearie me. Okay, well, this is one for the outtakes. Oh, I'm walking towards a wolf. Oh, it probably doesn't really matter at this point. Goodbye. Oh, dear. Oh, we've gone. Well, okay, that lasted, according to my stopwatch, all of 8 minutes. Okay, right, that's one for the outtakes. And what we're going to do is we're going to start again. Oh, dear, that went wrong. Okay, so we're going to Stalker mode. We'll go into Forlorn Muskeg. We'll start as our friend. We're going to say return to Stalker, and we are going to go back in. Okay, so let's press any key to continue, and let's load up. I do like some of these insightful quotes that they come up with. Right, let's have a look at our situation then. We have 6 hours of daylight left. We are in a blizzard. It's not very pleasant. And I really have no idea where we are. I'm gonna go in here. Is this a cave? No, it's not. It's just a pass through. I don't really know where we are. I don't know this map that well. Oh, okay. I know where we are. I've got an idea. I know where we are. Perfect. Right, okay. Let's collect some sticks. We're going to need this firewood. And at the moment, there's very, very little... very little in the way of food out here. So we're going to have to... take the mushrooms, about the only source we have. We're gonna need all of the sticks that we can see. Okay, there's a wolf over there. I don't want to get my face eaten off by that. I know where we are, because there is the train cars. And if you remember, in the previous series, we made it there. That's where we made it, the far side of the lake. There's a hunting stand there, which is probably a good place to go to start with. So let's head for that. Yeah, so I've done a little bit of exploration. In pilgrim mode, which some people might consider cheating slightly, but I didn't want to try coming back here again in Stalker after what happened last time. I don't want to end a Stalker game by just going into a new region and making a complete mess of it. So what I decided to do is just come in pilgrim and have a bit of a wander around, and I've learned a few things from it. I have learned where a couple of locations are, one of which is quite close to me. Quite close to where I am now, which I'm hoping will come in handy. Another thing that I've discovered is the weak ice. I figured out the pattern of weak ice. Pretty much any wide section of ice on the map, on the Forlorn Muskeg region, is weak. If you try and walk across it, it will collapse. Oh, hello. What we got here? Oh, a skeleton. Oh, an actual skeleton. Look at that. Human skeleton. That's the first time we've seen anything like that in the Long Dark. We've never really seen that kind of thing before. Okay, we're at risk of hypothermia. We don't really have time to be looking at things like that. I really do think the Long Dark's going to take a bit of a dark turn when it goes to story mode. Oh, survive the outdoors. Perfect. I'm one of those. And some antiseptic. And a hacksaw. And a backpack. Well, we do know, of course, that Forlorn Muskeg has the forge on it. Obviously, I can start a fire here. It's just, I've only got sticks to start it with. 5 hours left, minus nine. Okay, let's try lighting a fire. Because I don't want to get hypothermia, really, if I can avoid it. Let's light it right here by the entrance. And we will... we've got two pieces of cedar firewood, so that should give us a reasonably good duration fire. So let's get this lit.
Come on, little fire!
Obviously, we're back to square one again. We're back to base level on just about everything. So we need to build all our skills back up again. So we're probably going to have a few failed fires. But that one worked. Okay, I'm going to chuck one piece of cedar and I'm going to chuck half my logs on. So that's going to give me a 2 hour fire. I'm going to get up onto the hunting stand, duck down, and hopefully... oh, it's still minus one. Zero, one. There we are. I'm just going to sit right here in the doorway. Three, four, I'm near the fire. Five, there we are. But I'm protected. So I'm going to stay here for a little bit and see if we can't get our temperature up. So let me pass time for an hour. There we go. So that's got our temperature up a little bit. We've got about an hour's duration left on that fire. Yep. Okay, well, from up here Let's do some cook any water. Okay, that's fine. Well, we can, let's make a liter of water. If I have to chuck more fuel on the fire, I will do. There we are. And let's boil that water. Although, before we do, let me just chuck a couple of extra sticks on. There we are. We'll boil that water. Make our first little batch of water. And then I'm going to cook the reishi mushroom. Okay, so we now have reishi tea in our inventory. Which used two mushrooms. If I can find it. Oh, it's in medical, isn't it? Because it's counted as a medical thing. But I'm actually going to drink it because it's hot and it gives me 100 calories. I've got a little bit of water. I've got some of those, So we're actually, at the moment, as a starting point, we're not doing too bad. Obviously, we now have a warmth bonus. We'll warm up a little bit quicker. We're still standing next to the fire, of course. Right. We've got 19 minutes left on the fire. I don't want to waste any of this fire heat. So what I'm going to do, I am going to pass time for an hour, but I'm going to cancel it as soon as the fire goes out. There we are. So, let's get ourselves moving again. And I'm going to head this way, around the back. We've got 3 hours of daylight remaining. It's minus 14. So we've done alright so far. And if you recognise this from the previous video, these are the rail cars which were kind of over towards the far end of the rail tracks where we ultimately ended up during our failed previous Stalker series where we tried to come over here and explore it, which I didn't do particularly well. I didn't really do that properly at all. I shouldn't have got overexcited and shouldn't have just run across it like I did. I should have turned around and gone back and waited, but, you know. The benefit of a game is that you live and learn from these silly mistakes. In real life, of course, there's no reset button, but in the game there is, so. We started all over again, and we are back here now. Right, okay, so. We are very close to the end of this particular line. That's where it closes down. Now, I think there is, I can't remember exactly where it is, some sort of abandoned campsite near here where there's a snow shelter. Oh, unless it's at the other side. Oh, it might be on the other side, actually. It might be towards the entrance, not towards this side. I can't really remember. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to head round this way. I've only got 3 hours, but the hunting stand is definitely not the best place to try and hole up for the complete night, so I'm going to keep trying to make my way round to find somewhere a bit better. And obviously I don't even have the option to make a snow shelter because you need cloth to make snow shelters. You need sticks as well, but we've got plenty of those. It's the cloth that we don't have. Okay, so this is what I've learned about the ice sheet as we head down towards it. If you cross on the relatively narrow sections between these snowy islands, you should be okay. They seem to be fine, but if you cross the wider sections of ice, they are weak and you will fall through them. It's as simple as that. So, the trick to navigating this region is to passing around the ice sheets on the narrow sections so that you don't risk falling through the ice. Now, in theory, that should be relatively straightforward, but the problem with it is if you encounter wolves or if you encounter bears or other hostile wildlife, they can block off the routes that you need to be taking and you can find yourself in trouble. So because you've essentially got a very select number of pathways that you can take, you could end up in a spot of bother. Now, we have a little cave here, but to me this looks like a bear cave, so I'm not entirely sure whether we want to hole up in it or not. It's either a bear cave or a wolf cave. It doesn't seem to have given us any real temperature advantage. Obviously, if we light a campfire, that will give us a temperature advantage. I think what we're going to be doing at the moment, until we've gathered up a bit more material, is doing these very sort of very short campfires, sleeping for a few hours and then moving on again. So,
come on, little fire.
This is probably what I'm going to do now. Just do another short campfire. So this is very different to how we start in Mystery Lake, where there's lots of man-made structures and we can get shelter very quickly and very easily. Here, it's completely different, because ultimately you've got far fewer resources. There's very few man-made structures on this map. So there's very few man-made shelters, and there's very little salvage, if you like, very little loot that you're going to find while you're out here. So it's really quite, it is a challenge starting on this map, and that's partly why I decided to do it, because, oh goodness sake, come on, I can't keep doing this too often, because I'm going to run out of tinder if I'm not careful, and matches. If I've got any accelerant, I'm using it next time if this doesn't light. Come on, we just need you to light. Come on. Light, damn you. I think we've got it. Yeah, we've got it. Right. I'm going to bung that on, and I'm going to bung on some of my sticks. So this is going to give me an hour and a half, which will warm me up. Kind of. Let's chuck another stick on. If we can get a little bit more, coax a little bit more heat out of this fire, and then we'll put our bedroll down right next to it and sleep for an hour. Okay, so I can pass time for a little bit, can't I? Let's do that. Okay, cancelling. Coming out. It's gone dark now. Oh god, do you know what? We might end up not surviving this, you know. Right, we're travelling at night. It's minus 14 degrees. I know it is very cold, but there isn't very much we can do about it. Okay, I'm going to head this way. What I'm trying to do is reach the far side of the map, because that is where the biggest building on the entire map is, and the place where we stand the best chance of keeping ourselves going until we can get off the map and get back to Mystery Lake. It's a bit like starting on Timberwolf Mountain, this. See, there we go. Nice narrow piece of ice, we can pass over it, and it's fine. And I'm hoping the same thing will apply here. That one's a little bit wider, but we're okay, we made it across. So again, narrow passages of ice like that you're okay with. Big wide pieces like that, it will be weak and you will fall through it. There's a wolf over there. I'm going to keep going this way. I'm actually not very far from where I'm aiming for. I can actually see what I'm aiming for right in front of me. It's whether I can actually get to it or not. Okay, I'm hoping I can make it across this bit of ice. Nope, no, that's weak ice. Let's get off it. Just go straight backwards to avoid falling through it. You have to be very quick. don't hang about. So we'll go around on the snow. Snowy stuff. We'll go this way. And we shall make our way across these bits of snow. Oh, what's the betting this is going to be weak ice? Hang on. Yep. Okay, back we go. You can actually tell by the sound. There is a sort of very distinctive sound that you will learn to understand when you've done this a few times as to when you're about to plummet through the ice. You have to get back off it as quickly as you can. Okay, can we make it across this bit? Yep. There we are, we're across. And we are at the farmstead. Now, one thing I will point out is that this is not actually a full indoor location. My understanding is that there are no actual, genuine, complete indoor locations on this map. So this is... Oh, tinder, birch bark. That makes very good tinder. We'll have that. There's a little sort of barn, but it's completely open. The best building we've got is this one. But again, it's not a true indoor location, so it's still cold in here. It is not warm at all. But one of the big bonuses of being in here, this is where you're going to find the vast majority of the loot. But it's also where the forge is. I did find this on my last little pass through. This is where the forge is. We've got all these planks that we can use to make firewood, which I am very likely to do. I've got some sticks, but they're not really going to give me very much. But we'll get a fire lit in the furnace, because it is the only place we can easily light a fire in here. So we'll get a fire going. I'm not planning on forging anything here. What I'm planning on doing is just getting the fire lit, because then it'll warm up the building and it'll get us out of the freezing. This is the best shelter there is on Forlorn Muskeg. For anyone who hasn't been on this region, this is the best shelter that I certainly have found. I haven't fully explored the map, even in Pilgrim mode. I just had a want a little quick circle around it. I can't put the coal on. It has to have burned for at least half an hour before I can do that. Yep. So hopefully we can get some coal on before the fire completely burns out. Ah, we've got some fir firewood. I want some cedar firewood. Perfect, we can bung that in. We've got some shoes there. Some boots. It's a little bit warmer under here. But there is actually a bed upstairs. The planks here allow you to get up there, so don't go harvesting them, for goodness sake. Okay, let's chuck the fir on. A piece of the fir and that piece of cedar. That gives us a warmer fire. Try and look after our resources. We've got wolves wandering about. Obviously, this is an open building. They can come in here and get you. If you walk up here, I don't know how secure you'll be. We've got some reclaimed wood. We can also chuck that on the fire. Can I do it from up here? Because that would just be awesome. Oh, I can't, no. Come down the ramp. Okay, let's chuck this reclaimed wood on the fire. We'll chuck all of that on. That'll increase the heat output. Have we hit a point where I can bug a bit of coal on? No, I've still got to wait a little bit longer. But at least we are now above freezing. That's a good start. I need a hatchet to break those planks down. If I come up here, I can break down the crate. So I'm going to do that. Okay, we've gone back to being cold up here. Okay, let's chuck ourselves some more reclaimed wood on the fire. That'll give us another long duration fire. And while we're here, we might as well make some water. So that'll get us nice and warmed up. And we get ourselves some water made.
You know, that guy who drank his own pee doesn't seem so crazy right about now.
Oh, don't worry, we're dealing with it. For goodness sake. There we go. That's better. Perfect. It's starting to get light now. 7 hours of darkness left, so this is the night time that I can finally show you. You can see the stars. It's a bit blizzardy, but you know, this is the view that you get at night if it's clear in the long dark, and it really is quite nice. Okay, so what I'm thinking of doing, I'm going to set my camp up in here if I can place my bedroll down. Simply because I feel it's... Didn't mean to do that. I feel it's more secure. I feel a little bit safer under here. Okay, I'm just going to sleep for 3 hours. So the fire shouldn't have gone out. But it will just help us recover a bit of our condition. And get a little bit of our sleep rested back. Oh, it didn't. Cause it didn't do that because I forgot to drink before I slept. Oh, ha, ha, ha. Just gonna eat a little bit as well, and we'll sleep for a little bit longer. And then obviously I'm gonna have to have a look how much longer I've got left on this fire. I need to completely out. An hour and 20 minutes left on it, so let's just chuck a piece of... I can chuck a piece of coal on now, can't I? Excellent, okay. Chuck some coal on, that really pumps up the heat. That really, really pumps the heat up. So it now feels like 25, 26, 27, it's brilliant. Okay, so we're going to sleep for 2 hours. And that will get us pretty much through to morning. And the fire is still burning. And we're obviously now well rested. Nice and warm. This really is the best location on this map for sheltering. We've got a workbench in here. Sewing kit, obviously a drawer with nothing in it. We have got another bedroll over here. We've got a locker. Anything in here?
Take it.
Oh, we've got some mittens. Probably come in handy. I need to review my clothing, actually. Oh, we've got a hatchet. Brilliant. Oh, that's what we needed, that. Chocolate bar. Some cured leather. We have a coat, a parka. And we have a storm lantern, which we didn't previously have. And there are some bits of scrap metal lying around. This is the forge, obviously, so the... Give you some scrap metal to keep you going. There's another hacksaw there. I'm going to leave the hacksaw. Let's break... let's not do that, actually. Let's have a look in the first aid kit. Got a bandage. Another bandage. Anything's better than nothing. I'm not going to complain. Coal. There are some other buildings knocking around as well, but the last time I had a nosy round, there wasn't really that much in any of them. We've got a jerry can with some fuel in it. We have some newsprint that we can use. Obviously we have this bed, we have some more socks. Let's go into the clothing system. As you can see, we're not really wearing a great deal at the moment, so let's have a look. Oh yes, those boots are a lot better. Let's put those boots on. We are wearing sport socks and wool socks. We can actually put the wool socks on as well. We can put two pairs of socks on. Gives us a real benefit. Head over to here. We have ragged fleece mittens and decent fleece mittens. The decent ones obviously give us slightly better condition. I don't have any kind of hat of any description, so my nose is bright red, as you can see. I can wear my parka. So there we go. So we've got a slightly better warmth bonus now. Obviously we're up on high. I can hear the wolves knocking around. That's going to go out fairly soon. It's tricky because I want to keep the coal for when I want to do some forging, but equally I don't want the fire to go out at the moment if I can avoid it. Although that said, I know we've got on the fire 2 hours. How long is that going to take me? 30 minutes. Let's do it. Okay, there we go. So we're gonna go. I'll take that other hacksaw as well. We've got ourselves some more reclaimed firewood. See, at the minute, what I'm doing is just trying to keep the fire going. by chucking fuel at it, so it doesn't go out. I can't break that down. I've got some rifle rounds there. That's quite good. What we've got going on in here then? Well, we've got some crates. We can break down for reclaimed wood. Wow! And a whole load of dog food that was hiding underneath the crate. I'll go with that. And there's a safe behind here. Oh wow, okay. Right, before we go any further, how much longer have I got on the fire?
I could eat anything.
Dog food, do you? Let's chuck a bit of reclaimed wood on the fire, give ourselves a decent, good fire. And let's cook up some reishi mushroom tea. Which again, I know it's supposed to be a medicine item, but it will also keep us going. It gives us a few calories, gives us some water, and of course it's going to give us that warmth bonus, which is going to come in handy. Although to be fair, right at the moment it doesn't really matter because the forge is chucking a lot of heat out. Let's see if we can break into this safe then. Standard practice for breaking into safes, if you've seen me do this in the Long Dark before. Keep on spinning. That was 24, wasn't it? So back to zero. Spin back round to 24. And we'll go back. Oh, missed it. I wasn't even looking at it. I think it was about 5. There we go, we're in. And there's nothing in it! Oh, I'm really disappointed now. Oh, I thought that was awesome there. Hidden safe, hidden behind all those crates. That'd be brilliant. Nothing in it. Right, okay, so. We've pretty much raided all of this now, haven't we? Is there anything out the back of here? I don't know if there's anything around any walls or anything. What have we got around the back of here? Well, this is all part of the forge, I think. Ah! Okay, the wolves really are a bit bold. I'm going to come up here. Little off. I'm actually curious as to whether the wolves can actually get me up here. It's unfortunately no way to know without tempting one to attack me, which, to be honest, I'd rather not do. But I'm going to do it just for experimental purposes. In theory, of course, in real life, a wolf would very easily be able to get up here, but. Where is he? Oh, he's there, but he's hiding. Whoa! He's attacked me through the wall! Well, I'm putting that down as a... Oh, you've got to be kidding me! Well, that sucks! What? I was inside the building! How did he get me? Through the wall! Oh, well, there we are. That was a short series. Oh, well, that's a bit of an anticlimax, really, that one. Oh, how did he get me? He got me through the wall! The wall was there! There was a wall between me and the wolf. And not only that, but he killed me in one go. How low was my condition? I probably should have been paying a little bit more attention to what my condition... 65%, I'm assuming it was. And he just took me out in one go, practically. Oh, I'm really quite disappointed there. Well, that's a bit pants. Well, that's a record for the shortest time I have ever survived in the long dark. So I'm going to say thank you very much for watching, and we'll be back for a third attempt at Stalker Sandbox. And I ain't starting in Forlorn Muskeg next time. I've done it once, I ain't doing it again. I'll see you again soon. We'll do it next time.